Hello, Power BI community. This is the June edition of the Power BI Monthly Update. I'm Jason Himmelstein, Principal PM Manager for Content Strategy in Microsoft Fabric. For more information on the topics in this video, check out the update blog. The link is in the video description below. Let's get started. Power BI reporting. Visual Calc's update in preview. You've asked and we have delivered. Scatterplots are now supported within Visual Calcs. This means you can now add a visual calc to a scatterplot. Please note that the play axis is not yet supported. We've added a highlight to the visual matrix to indicate which visual calc you are editing. We plan to rely on the visual matrix to make working with visual calcs even easier in the future. This highlight is just the first step in our plans. To top it off for this month in the Power BI reporting section, we're adding a new visual calc exclusive function called lookup. Lookup makes it easy to find values in the visual matrix by specifying which value you want to use as a filter on any axis of the visual matrix. Anything that is not explicitly specified is inferred for context. For example, let's say you have a visual matrix that shows sales per color. The new Power BI Home in Power BI Desktop is now generally available. Introduced last February, this update brings new functionalities that makes it easier for users to create reports. With data sources directly accessible from the home screen, enhanced digital discoverability features like the recommendation sections, and the quick access list, getting started is simpler than ever. Power BI modeling. We are thrilled to announce that you can finally download your large semantic models to Power BI Desktop as a PBIX file. This unblocks the end-to-end authoring experience in Power BI Desktop for large semantic models. Dive into our documentation and discover more about this highly anticipated feature, including its capabilities and limitations. New info functions are now available in June of 2024. All info functions are DAX function versions of the existing Analysis Services Dynamic Management Views, or DMVs. All info functions can now take optional input parameters. As DMVs, these optional input parameters are called restrictions. For all info functions, this includes their columns, but some have additional restrictions. Info.calc dependencies can specify query as one of its restrictions or optional input parameters, allowing you to analyze the items in the semantic model needed for that DAX query. This is very helpful when analyzing what is being used by the semantic model in a DAX query for a visual in the report. We've heard your request and added the ability to use DAX Query View while live connected to a published semantic model. With this release, you can write DAX queries with DAX Query View when live connected to a published semantic model in Power BI Desktop. This includes live connecting to the amazing Direct Lake semantic models created in Microsoft Fabric. Live connect to your published data lake, import, direct query, or composite semantic model in Desktop and use DAX Query View to quickly view data without having to create visuals. Use quick queries to have a DAX query generated for you from any table, column, or measure. And Copilot can help you write your DAX queries as well. Power BI Mobile. We strive to make the Power BI mobile app as accessible as possible for everyone. That's why in this month's update, we've added Show Visuals as Table as a view mode to all reports. Use this feature to instantly view all the visuals, excluding slicers, cards, and non-data-driven visuals in your report as table visuals. This feature enhances the consumption experience for users who rely on screen readers by allowing them to read the underlying data presented in each visual. It's also beneficial for users who prefer to consume their data in tabular form, which is more like the consumption experience in Excel. Power BI developers. We're very excited to announce the Power BI Enhanced Report Format, PBIR, for Power BI Project Files, PBIP. This marks a significant milestone in achieving the primary goal of Power BI Desktop Developer Mode, which is to provide source control-friendly file formats that unblocks co-development and enhances development efficiency. Power BI Projects, PBIP, now support saving the report and semantic model into a folder using source control friendly formats, and PBIR for the file format for report, and TMDL, TMDL, for the semantic model. Next up, let's check out a demo by Rui Romano on the Power BI Enhanced Report Format.
Power BI Developer Mode allows you to save your Power BI developments into a folder with metadata text files. One of its promises and pillars is to deliver a good source control and code development experience. To achieve that goal, it's very important to have source control friendly file formats that not only will let you easily track and understand all your changes, but also minimize the occurrence of complex merge diffs while working with others. Back in February, we made a big step in that direction by bringing the tabular model definition language, TMDL, into Power BI Desktop, saving your semantic model metadata as a folder with a TMDL document for each table, perspective, culture, and more. Not only was a big improvement for source control, but also for professional semantic model development using the TMDL language with Visual Studio Code. And this month, I'm very excited to announce the Power BI Enhanced Report Format, also known as PBIR, which is a very important milestone for the Power BI team because it's the first time ever we are making public, with documentation, our report format. Not only it will provide a great source control and co-development experience, because each visual page bookmark will have its own properly formatted JSON file with a JSON schema that will also allow you to understand what each property means, unblocking a ton new set of opportunities to enhance your report development efficiency, like applying batch edits or easily reuse report objects like visuals and bookmarks between reports. Let's go for a demo. So PBIR is in public preview, and if you enable the preview feature, now, when saving as a Power BI project, instead of a single report.json file, you will have a definition folder using the PBIR format. You can easily navigate to that folder using the title flyout. Let's open the definition folder with Visual Studio Code, and notice that now the JSON is properly formatted and the report definition is split into multiple files, where each visual has its own individual file, which is very convenient for version control, but also code development. And on each file, you will encounter a JSON schema. Not only will that conveniently describe each property meaning with a simple mouse over, but it will also provide syntax validation if you end-author the file, and you will also get IntelliSense if you want to create a new property. With PBIR, it's now better than ever to granularly track all your report changes. Let's make a few changes in our report and look at the diffs using VS Code and Git. Let's save the report, navigate to the PBIP folder, and open the folder in VS Code to look at the changes. Clicking on the Source Control tab, we can now see two diffs on two visuals and understand what have changed. One visual changed its type, and another visual changed its background color. A big goal of PBIR is to improve efficiency and reusability. And an example of that is the support of simple copy and paste of files between reports. For example, you can now easily reuse pages and bookmarks from other reports, something you cannot do using the UI. This report has a slicer configuration I want to reuse in my report. If I save it as a PBIP using PBIR, I can navigate to its PBIR folder definition and copy the bookmark files from the definition folder of this report to the definition folder of the report I'm developing. And repeat the process for the page that has the slicer pane. Because I'm changing files externally, I must restart Power BI Desktop and reopen the PBIP for those changes to be reflected in my report. And I can confirm that the new page is there, with the slicer panel and the bookmark configuration working fine. And of course, because the semantic model is different, the visuals of the page are going to be in error, But I can easily fix that by changing the configured field on each visual, and in this case, on each slicer. And this is it. The main takeaways are that now with the PBIR and developer mode, we finally have a public and documented report format, a good source control and code development experience, and also new ways to improve our efficiency working with Power BI reports.
Power BI visualizations. We have new visuals in AppSource this month. Check out the monthly blog update for a more in-depth look at these visuals. Word Cloud by PowerViz, Drill Down Timeline Pro by ZoomCharts, Attribute Control Chart by Nova Silva, Download Button by JTA. Power BI Paginated Reports. You can now open reports that are in folders and subfolders from Power BI Report Builder. These reports may reside in folders and subfolders in workspaces that the user has access to. You can also publish paginated reports to folders and subfolders that you have access to in the Power BI and Fabric service. Power BI Spotlight Member. That's it for the updates. Each month, we highlight a community member that's making a positive impact in our community. Meet my fellow Texas resident, Rumbayat Yasmin, who is a super user in our community. Rumbayat has been a Power BI community member since May of 2023. In that time, she has authored over 150 solutions and has over 700 replies. Rumbayat is a valued moderator for Microsoft Learn Together sessions and has gone above and beyond in the community to help us. One thing about Rumbayat, she loves using Power Automate and Logic apps to let those robots do the heavy lifting while she enjoys a nap. If that's not the definition of working smarter, not harder, I don't know what is. Thank you for being a part of our community, Rumbayat. Well, that's all for this month. Please visit our Power BI community forums at aka.ms/PBI community. It's the best place for you to connect with others to get answers to your questions. And please, tell us how we can do better. We are listening. Like, comment, subscribe, and thanks for watching.